I said an onion in Minnesota.
Hey guys, my name is Mike Beck, owner of Southern Indiana Sawmill, and today I'm going to be doing a review on the Minimax MM20 Bandsaw. Minimax is not a name that is typically heard of in the woodworking market, even though it is a very high quality industrial piece of machinery. It's not the type of tool that you go into most of your local woodworking stores and you can find. The question that's going to come up in this review is the cost worth it for this kind of machine? Is it going to give you value for your money? And are you really getting what you pay for? That's what a lot of these things really just come down to anyhow. A little bit of a review on the Minimax MM20. This has a 20-inch flywheel top and bottom. It has a 4.8 horsepower motor. I'm guessing there's sort of a metric standard conversion. We would normally just say 5 horsepower, but whatever. A 4-inch dust port for collecting the dust. Minimum, this is important, minimum extraction CFM required out of your dust collector. It says 580. You'll find out later. I'm going to say it needs way more than that. The price for the MM16, which is the most popular bandsaw, sells for $3,395. The MM20 sells for $4,495. If you step up to the 24-inch resaw, you're looking at $5,695. And then they have bigger machines than that even. They have a 28-inch, a 32-inch, and a 36-inch. Sky's the limit. You can spend as much as you want. What you're getting is a bigger, heavier machine, really more resaw capability, bigger table to cut deeper things. So with that being said, let's go and look at a few more of the specifics of this machine. I'm going to tell you some things I really like about it. I'm also going to tell you in this review about a couple of the things that might even need improvement. All right, let's go ahead and get started. When you first buy this machine, you get this little toolkit that comes with it. You open it up. I might have put a couple extra wrenches or whatever in here in the time I've had it. You get this huge push stick as long as a person's arm. You get a few wrenches, a few little Allen wrenches and things like that that come in the box. You're also going to get, go over here, you get this little guide miter fence deal. Again, this is nothing super fancy. I think this is... That's extruded aluminum. I think the rest is probably cast steel or something like that. But yeah, just little things like that are some of the basics that come with the machine. All right, guys, so I have a smaller shop. It's important for me, even if I have a big, massive tool like this. I think it weighs somewhere in the neighborhood of 650 pounds. You still want to be able to move the machine if you have to. This goes up under the foot brake. A little bit of leverage, and you can lift this machine up, and you can roll it away pretty easy. All right, you remember that little toolkit that I showed you earlier, one of these Allen wrenches it comes with. It comes with these little Allen threaded bolts that you can screw into the bottom areas here. And what you can do with that is it helps you to level out the machine on the floor. Even machines as big as this, when you turn them on and you have big, powerful motors running them, are prone to vibration if you're not on a level floor. And so these will really help you level that out. And you'll be astounded at the difference that just a quarter turn on one of these will actually make on the smoothness of operation of the machine. Let's take a look at the upper flywheel on the Minimax MM20. Solid piece of cast and machined cast iron. This is an exceptionally heavy flywheel, and unless you see it in person, it's really hard to understand, but if you're used to smaller bandsaws, this thing will take you by surprise. All right, let's take a peek underneath the machine here real quick. This is the underside of the machine, the bottom flywheel. You can see the pulley there. There's a brush to catch dust and stuff from coming off of the wheel. The bottom guides, and there's this little block here that you can replace that with any block, of course, and that sort of fits in the way of the blade to help with dust extraction. This bottom guide can also be moved up and down. All you got to do is take that bolt, loosen it, and you can drop it up or down, whether you want more tension going up on the top or if you want it to be a little bit looser going further towards the bottom. This is one of the safety limit switches that is on the top and bottom doors of the machine. There's also one attached to the foot brake that shuts the machine off if you happen to touch that.
The fence that comes with this, very easy to move back and forth, typical mechanism there, locking it down. You can see underneath just how thick that fence is. It's about a quarter inch on each side between the center parts that you see there. So yeah, very heavy fence, very robust. It has a little bolt here that you can undo and set your drift one way or the other. It's very simple, and sometimes simple is the best way to do on machines like this. I apologize for the horrible lighting back here, folks, but this is part of the tilting table mechanism. Once you get it undone there, it's fairly easy to tilt this table back and forth. I don't hardly ever do that, as you can probably tell from the video.
Okay, so my very first issue that I have with this, I'm not going to call it a major complaint, but the first issue that I have is that sometimes this start and stop switch seems to work intermittently. But it's not like a typical start-stop, that it's going to start no matter what and it's going to stop. This machine does not start no matter what. Sometimes it seems a little bit finicky. Again, it's one of those safety type deals. I think mostly it's a good thing that we have this safety equipment on, but sometimes it's a hindrance because they can be a little bit finicky. The second of the three complaints that I have related to this machine has to do with the dust collection system. This thing can make a ton of dust. I'll tell you what happens. This looks like it would catch all of the dust right in this area because of the way that that's designed, and it would just naturally flow into the dust port. But when you close the door, there's a small gap on here that allows the dust to go down past that area, down to the bottom part of the machine, and a lot of the dust gets flung up through the machine because of the spinning blade and ends up on top of your head. That can be easily improved by just putting a little bit of gasketing on here. I hate to say it, but you know, when you spend $4,500 on a machine, you'd think that something like that would be a lot more thought out. And I have a fairly powerful dust collector, and a lot of it does not go in there because of that. The third issue that I would have with this machine, and this is by no means a big deal, is this particular mechanism. Sometimes I'll raise this up, and see, I'm pulling, and that is not going up any further, so I have to take and sort of wiggle it a little bit until I can get it to go all the way up. Sometimes it will stick, and sometimes it does not. Not a big deal. But you know, that's just the way it is. Not every day that you raise this machine all the way up anyhow, so it doesn't bother me, but it's just one of those other things. That's enough talking about the machine for now. I want to show you guys how this actually cuts. I'm going to be cutting a piece of sapele, and I'm going to be cutting these pieces 1/8 of an inch thick. Alright guys, so there's a little bit of proof that the machine actually works. And let me tell you, it works fantastic. I've never put anything into this that it cannot cut. All the way up to 20 inch complete resaw capacity on this machine. I just did these little pieces to give you a little demo. This machine is not, this video is not primarily about you watching the machine run. Now, how many pieces would you suppose is in that? Well, the video showed me cutting two. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All from that single block right there. And as you can see, these are all cut about 1/8 of an inch thick. So if resawing is what you're into, if it's what you want to do, this machine is going to do this for you all day long. So overall, I have to rate this machine about a 9 out of a 10, just because of those couple little things that I put in there. If it weren't for that, it would be like a 12 out of 10. We'd have to turn it all the way up past perfect for this machine. The machining on it is top notch. You are going to get what you pay for, and that is the biggest deal. So don't be afraid if you're scoping out new bandsaws. Perhaps you've never even heard of the SCM group or Minimax. By the way, I don't get paid by anybody. So you don't have to worry about, you know, do I have bias here or whatever. I was in the market for a bandsaw for a long time. I would have understood if their representative got totally upset with me and just said, forget it, you're never going to buy it. Because it took me a good several months, almost a year, to decide what my next bandsaw was going to be. And this is the one that I decided on. I'm very, very happy that I made that purchase. It cuts like a dream. I never had any cutting issues with this machine at all. It does exactly what it's designed to do, which is what we as woodworkers want it to do. So in my instrument making and furniture building, I use this regularly. Let me tell you just one point. One of the things the rep told me, he said, when you buy this machine, you might never go back to using your table saw regularly ever again. And I thought that that was just a bunch of malarkey. Like, that is not going to be true. Let me tell you, most of the things that I cut now, I just wheel this thing out and I will cut it on here. It makes such a nice quality cut that it's pretty much a table saw quality cut. You get that blade aligned and running properly, and the cut is second to none. And so I really do use this, probably use this tool the most in my shop of any of the tools that I own now. And most importantly, I really enjoy using it. It's a safe machine. And overall, I feel like I've gotten my money's worth out of it. So if you are in the market, hopefully this review is going to help you in making your decision. I enjoy it, and as always, you can send me emails if you want. You can either go through YouTube, or you can go through the business, southernindianasawmill@gmail.com. My name is Michael Beck. I'm the owner of Southern Indiana Sawmill, which is a portable sawmill service. We can take your tree all the way from lying on the ground to a finished piece of heirloom quality furniture, should you desire, or we're just available for general milling services. So if you happen to be around the Southern Indiana or Kentucky area, drop me a line. I'd love to tell you anything more you want to know about bandsaw purchasing, specifically the Minimax, or if you have any general sawmilling needs, just give me a call. All right, guys. Hope you have a good one. I will talk to you later.